Hi there, my name is Jason Harlow. Welcome to the second lesson in the Introduction to Physics Primer. We're finishing off chapter one in today's video. I just want to talk about accuracy and precision, uncertainty, and significant figures. So here are two kinds of scales. There's a pan balance and there's a spring scale here. And they're both used to measure mass. And we put them here just to remind you that science depends on measurements. You have to do experiments, measure numbers, and compare them with theories in order to make good progress in science. And in real life, if you try to measure the same thing in two different ways, you will often get different results. Or even if you measure it in the same way but repeat the measurement again and again, you get this scatter of measurements, and sometimes you get a histogram. Which looks like a little bell curve. And the reason is that no measurement you make is exact. There's always a degree of uncertainty. So on that note, we define accuracy and precision. So accuracy is how close a measurement is to the correct value for that measurement. And precision refers to how close the agreement is if you make the same measurement again and again and again. So how precise you are is often portrayed by how many decimal places that you put. So, for example, this is from the text. It's about a GPS system that's trying to locate a restaurant at the center of a bullseye. So if you take four different measurements with your GPS, and they're in different positions, but they're all kind of scattered around the center, that's accurate. It is telling you correctly where the restaurant is, but it's not very precise. Because the scatter is so large. You can reduce, or increase the precision, but if your GPS is systematically wrong somehow, then this is not accurate. It's missed the bullseye. So numerically, we know pi is the ratio of the circumference of a circle to its diameter. If you say that pi equals 3, well, that's actually accurate. It could be rounded, right? So that's accurate, but it's not precise. If you say that pi is equal to 3.24159, that's a very precise number, but unfortunately it's not accurate. That's not pi. So to be precise and accurate, you would say pi equals 3.14159. That's got a six significant figure precision, and it is accurate. So I'll just mention uncertainty, plus or minus uncertainty. You can specify the range of values associated with a measurement by uncertainty. And I just actually said that no measurement is exact. That's not quite true. If I look at this pile of apples and count them, I can say that they're exactly three apples. So there is a rare case where the uncertainty in my measurement is actually zero. For most other things, if I measure my height or if I actually count apples again, but now how many apples are in the back of this truck, it's just harder to do it, right? So in practice, you would say the number of apples in this back of this truck might be 1,600 plus or minus 100. So 1,600 is what we call the value, and 100 is the uncertainty. It's a number which specifies some range. So by using a numerical uncertainty, you eliminate the need to say, oh, it is approximately 1600, or use the squiggly equals sign. It gives you a quantitative way of stating your confidence level in your measurement. So if you say it's 1600 plus or minus 100, what you mean there in science is that you're 68% confident that the actual number is between 1600 minus 100 and 1600 plus 100. So moving on, significant figures. So if you say that a length is 6.2 meters, you're implying that the actual value is between 6.15 and 6.25, and somebody has rounded the value off to 6.2. So we say that the 6 and the 2 are significant. These are two significant figures. If you had a more precise measurement, you could give more significant figures. So, and that's determined by how you actually made the measurement, right? So the data provided gives you, tells you how many significant figures you should report. So 6 and 2. if you have zeros in your measurement, you have to give a special consideration. For example, 0.053. The zeros here are not significant because they're just placekeepers to locate the decimal place. Okay, you have to write this zero. If you just wrote 5.3, you wouldn't know that it was actually 5/100ths and 3/1000ths. However, if you write 10.053, now these zeros are not placekeepers, but they're actually significant. You know that it has to be a zero. This is measured to be a zero, and this is measured to be a zero. If you write 1300, you may or may not have these zeros be significant. If you were saying, oh, maybe about 1300, then maybe it's between 1250 and 1350, then they're not significant. But maybe you knew that there's exactly 1300. We don't know. So zeros are significant except when they serve only as placekeepers. So let's do some examples. Okay, the first step in understanding significant figures is being able to count how many sig figs are in a particular number. So 3.05. Well, 3 is significant, 0 and 5, they're all significant, so the number of sig figs is 3. 3 sig figs. 0.620. Well, the 6 is significant, the 2 is significant, the 0 is significant, but this one is not. This is a placeholder. So just put an arrow to that, and that again is 3 significant figures. What about the next one? 52,100. Well, certainly the 5 and the 2 and the 1 are significant, but the zeros here at the end, I think, are just placeholders. So again, I would count that as 3 significant figures. However, if people put a .0 after that, then all of a sudden, the 5 is significant, the 2 is significant, this 1 is significant, and now all these zeros become significant. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 significant figures. So this is, it can be a bit ambiguous, so a nice way to write 52,100 is 5.21 times 10 to the 4. This is very clearly 3 significant figures, whereas with this one up here, we're not quite sure whether those last two zeros are significant or not. So this one we know for sure. 5.001, this is significant, this is, and this is, so that's 4 significant figures. 0.0012, only the 1 and the 2 are significant, whereas these ones all seem to be placeholders. And so this is just 2 significant figures. And a better way perhaps to write that is 1.2 times 10 to the minus 3, same number, but clearly you can see here this has 2 significant figures. Okay, so why don't you give it a try? Which of the following numbers has the most number of significant figures? 8200, 0.0052, 0.430, 4 times 10 to the minus 23, or 8000.01. So press pause, figure it out, and then you'll see what the answer is. Okay, so hopefully you got E. So with 8200, I'm going to assume that the zeros, these two zeros, are not significant. So this just has 2 significant figures. For B, 0.0052, these are definitely just placekeepers. So only the 5 and the 2 are significant. That's 2. This first zero is a placekeeper, but this last zero, the only reason you'd write it there is if it was measured. So that is a significant zero. So that's 3. All this 10 times, or times 10 to the power something, that's giving you the order of magnitude, so that none of this is significant, just the 4 is, so that's 1. And then here, all these intermediate zeros are actually definitely significant because they're bounded on the left and the right by non-zero numbers. So that's got 6. Okay, so when doing a calculation, the number of significant digits in the final answer should be no greater than the number of significant digits in the least precise measured value. So, and in fact, there's 2 different rules. This one's for multiplication and division, and there's a different rule for addition and subtraction. For multiplication and division, you just do what we just said. So the result should have the same number of significant figures as the quantity having the least number of significant figures that you used in the calculation. So for example, if the radius of a circle is known to two significant figures, 1.2 meters, and you want to find the area, pi you actually know to many, many significant figures, so you can multiply this out and get this on your calculator, 4.52389 34, but that's listing too many significant figures because you started with 1.2, so you should end with just 4.5 meters squared. You should round this off to 4.5. For addition and subtraction, the rule is that the answer can contain no more decimal places than the least precise measurement. So for example, if you have three numbers you want to add, 7.56 plus 6.052 plus 13.7, if you did this on your calculator, you get 15.208. However, one of these measurements was only measured to the 10th place, and so you should round your final answer also to the 10th place. So you should report 15.2 kilograms. Okay, here's a problem, the example problem for significant figures. You travel 163 meters in 120 seconds. What was your average speed? Okay, so the distance is 163.1 meters. Time is 120 seconds. We know that average speed is distance divided by time. So that's 163.1 divided by 120. So if I just do that on my calculator, I end up with, let's see here, 163.1 divided by 120. I get 1.35916667. So clearly this is way too many significant figures. If we look at these numbers, D has four significant figures and T has two significant figures. The rule is the weakest link, we use two for our final answer. So that means I have to round this final answer to two significant figures. So all these things don't matter. It's 1.35 rounds up to being 1.4. So 1.4 meters per second, don't forget the units, is the correct final answer. Okay, so why don't you give it a try? Here's a problem. A cart begins at rest and accelerates down a ramp with an acceleration of 0.518 meters per second squared. After 3.2 seconds, how far has it traveled? So you'll learn in future chapters that the equation you want to use for this question is d equals 1/2 at squared. And you can plug in these numbers, and if you do that, you would get 2.6526 on your calculator. So how should you best report this answer as your final answer? A, 2.65216 meters. B, 2.65 meters, C, 2.60 meters, D, 2.6 meters, or E, 2.7 meters. Please think about that, give it a pause the video, and then we'll check your answer. Okay, so hopefully you reported 2.7. Basically, the weakest link here is the time. T equals 3.2 seconds. That has two significant figures. So you have to round this answer to two significant figures. So you can forget about the 2.216. You've got 2.65. Now my rule is that when the number ends with 5, 6, 7, or 8, or 9, you round it up, and numbers end in 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4, you round it down. So this ends in a 5, so you round up to 2.7 meters.